indigenous people already had a Green Deal thousands of years ago. They just didn't have a new deal because they didn't have the technology. What we have today, we have the technology to have green economy, clean energy, smart cars, which would be electronic cars, not owned by Tesla and so on, but they would be collective cars in my imagination, and so on. And basically what we are proposing as DiEM25 and Democracy in Europa is a Green New Deal for Europe, which would mean, I don't know if you remember, probably you know Fridays for Future, that recently when Greta went to Brussels to confront with Jean-Claude Juncker, then Jean-Claude Juncker, who is the guy famous that when he met Viktor Orban, he went like this and he said, "Hello, dictator." This is this guy who is joking that a dictatorship is happening in Europe. How he answered to Greta, he said, which was a bit surprising, but I will tell you what is wrong with it. He said, "Yes, we need billions of investments during the next 7 years." No, what we are proposing is that we need 500 billions of euros per year if in the next 5 years Europe wants to stop climate change. Then the question is, of course, how will you get the money? The money, how will you, I mean, read the program, but to explain it briefly, is something very similar to what Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and the Democrats in the US are doing now, is basically use the existing institutions to do something similar to what happened actually with the Bretton Woods system and with Roosevelt's New Deal. So in Europe, you would use the European Investment Bank who would issue bonds of the value of 500 billion euros. And at the same time, the European Central Bank would offer guarantees in the case that there is speculation, which would try to bring prices down. And by the very fact that the European Central Bank would give a guarantee, the prices wouldn't go down. By that money, you invest into green technology. By that money, you also actually work on a job guarantee. You have seen what's happening in the United States now with automation, artificial intelligence, and so on, where people who are working on airports, for instance, go to any airport, you will see that there is less and less humans, there are machines. So go to the US, you already have electric trucks. 3.5 million truck drivers in the US, which means more than 10 or 15 million who are connected, families, children, and so on, will be without a job in the next 10 years. So what will you do in that situation? One answer, which now I think that's really interesting, that Mark Zuckerberg, Bill Gates, Elon Musk, and everyone in Silicon Valley is actually advocating the universal basic income. What we are proposing is a universal basic dividend. And there is a big difference because the universal basic income would come from taxation, while the universal basic dividend would come from shares from a dividend from the companies. So it means something more radical than that. And by that, you actually give people the freedom to do what they want. And we have a green economy. It sounds like a dream, but unfortunately, when you look what you are doing, and I think I'm showing here to Fridays for Future and what is happening now in the United States, I think this might as well be the most important and maybe the last global protest ever, if we don't join it. And you have seen, unfortunately, that world leaders, it started with the Australian Prime Minister, who dismissed them. Then you had the Belgian Prime Minister who also said, oh, it's people, children are influenced by someone and so on. Then in the UK, when it started a few weeks ago, you had Theresa May saying that children are wasting valuable lesson time, as if the adults are much smarter or not wasting that time by doing wrong politics. And then Angela Merkel, which I think was a big disappointment, said that the children's protests were an outside influence, as if Putin came and they gave them candies and so on and so on. Feinstein, yes, thanks. Feinstein was the last example, yes, which happens in the United States, which I think she showed what is wrong
she
with democracy.
She went completely off the wall.
Dianne Feinstein, you mean, the senator?
Talking to the children,
So there are many other reasons for a Green New Deal. I expect, I mean, that if I may add as a footnote, that the establishment might soon, if they see that there is too much pressure, actually appropriate or try to co-opt the Green New Deal. But then we have to go a step further, as we always have to go.